webinar. This, I created this presentation together with my co-worker Francesca and Chiara. We are both involved in the project FINODEX. And you know, we worked. We meet a lot of time, I think, during the event organized by FINODEX. And the goal of this webinar is more for the people involved in FINODEX, and we want to improve the use of open data to be a perfect open data startup. So to the end of this session, you can read. You are, I hope you are ready to be a perfect open data startup after the reviewer of each reviewer involved in FINODEX. And the main point, the main goal are all publish correct open data and open the data to improve your business. Later, I'll show you some resources for open data. I think a lot of people involved, the best people involved in FINODEX received a report, the evaluation summary. And if you read, it is eligible. This means that you have a clear idea what is open data and what is fireware. In any case, the reviewer send you some feedback, and I think you have to read this handbook. We organized, we wrote this handbook to the beginning of the project. Inside there are some suggestions for entrepreneurs that are ready to use FINODEX, and if you can read, there is a section related to open data, the use of open data for your business and different kind of business model. But I think if you are here now, if you are in the top 10 finalists of FINODEX, you have a clear idea what is a business made with open data. What is very important is the reconnection to using open data set. And if you read the open definition, you have this clear idea what is open data. Open data means, open means anyone can freely access, use, modify, and share for any purpose. Subjected most requirement of preserved provenance and openness, but later I explain you better this. What happened from the finalist of FINODEX, the second call? Some reviewer give you some feedback like, you are agreed, you have agreed to the AI, your project is very nice, but you have to publish open data. You have to include more data. You have to use global resources. This is the three best points the feedback asked by the reviewer of FINODEX. And now we try to explain to you what is the right way to find everything, to find the solution. So, the question, publish open data, why and how? The suggestion of the reviewer is use it to improve your marketing strategy. The suggestion of the reviewer is pay attention to submission, ownership and privacy. And now, I want to try with you to find the solution. Why publish open data? In the different suggestion made by each reviewer, there is always there are some sentences, but the summary is only one. Open your data to create, to improve your marketing, to have a strategy to include more people, more customers around your system, around your application, and to expand your market to create a new connection with other people. This is the best point, the best goal, why, because a startup has to open the data. But open the data is always a problem, because you say, the data. The data is my treasure, my best asset of my company, and for this reason I need to understand how I have to open the data. And a lot of time during my presentation, during FINODEX, every time I meet some startups and other, I suggested this calculus. And I want to suggest you again, because I think it's very important to think about this in the point of view of as a startup. You can read that there is a calculus, very, very easy. On the left, PBD is the benefit. You think I open the data because I plan this kind of benefit. And on to the right are the costs. And if we speak about data, private data, data of a company, you can think, okay, but this is a cost. Why I have to open the data? Because if I open the data, my positive startup or the market is ready to use my data and I lost everything because of the asset of my company. This is a point, and this formula helps you to understand if it is a good idea for you open the data, yes or not. In any case, if you start to open the data, you have some benefit, you plan some benefit, and this is the benefit made by the reviewer. For example, if you say, improve your strategy, improve your marketing, and this is one of your benefits. But together, there is also the duty, the impact in the ecosystem about your company. Why you have to open the data? Maybe you are a big company and you want to open the data because it's very important to show to the other people what is your power, what is the benefit that you can produce for the society. But I show you better what is everything. This formula is very important. If you need the article, it's here. It's very easy to understand what is on the left. If what is on the left is more or on the right, you open the data. It's less, you can't open the data. So this is a schema to explain better everything. I don't want boring you to read everything here, but what is important is start to, on the left. So we speak about duty, the ecosystem impact. And if you read here in this article, this is the private sector, corporate social responsibility. Maybe this is the goal of your company, maybe it's not the goal of your company. By reading some projects for FINODEX, I found some example of company ready to work together with public administration, or ready to work with the customer. So maybe open the data. It's very important to explain to the other people. Maybe you say, it's very important because I collect a lot of this kind of data and the administration doesn't collect this data, or the other kind of question. You can say, okay, I can open the data because I think I have a very important impact for the society. But maybe it's better if you think about your benefit. And you have a lot of different attributes, accuracy, coverage, interoperability, sustainability, and other. You can read everything. Data quality, okay. You open the data because you can show what you have and the people can read it. But you are a startup, you are a company, and maybe it's better for you if you open good data. What is better for you maybe is the topic about monetization. And this is the suggestion made, the common suggestion made by the reviewer of FINODEX. The reviewer of FINODEX write to you, open the data, because with your data you can increase your network. You can increase your market, you can start a new connection with other people. So you say, okay, why? But why? Or how? And to open the data, you have to think that you can offer some data set to explain what is the power of your company. New data set or old data set. Because there is always the problem to access the data, to extract the data, to manage the data, to transform it in other kind of application. There is always the problem to have always fresh data. So you can think, okay, I offer you some of my data set, my data, and later, if you want it more, you have to pay. I use always the example of the shop of cheese. If you go in a shop of cheese, there is the cheese on the table. You can eat some pieces, but if you want, and this is free. But if you want to have the big cheese, you have to pay. And you can think about this kind of benefit. Offer some of your assets, some of your data, to have more customer or to create a relationship with other companies. Because the companies can say, if I combine your data with my data, I can improve my my profit. So you can say, oh, you have this data, you can read it, you can use it, and later you can explain to the other people what is better for you to create. But if you have the benefit, it's easy. Understand what are your benefits. Not so easy, but I think for a company, understand what is the possibility to create a new network should be easy, and offer the data is important. You need to add probability, and probability are not so easy to understand. If you read it on the first part of the calculus, is benefit multiplied for probability. So you have to work a lot about probability. Of sure, if you standard, it's very easy. One of the role that I find in the proposals and the companies involved in FINODEX is to collect the data to collect different kind of data with different standard, with different model, and create only one model. The model is good for the company, but this model can be very good for other companies. So if you standard, you conquer the world very, very fast. You can also try to create a new standard. It's not so easy, but maybe you can try to offer open data with a standard, and the standard you say, this is the standard commonly used by around the world. If you have you are in a field where nobody is present, you can try to create a standard with a lot of documentation. But what is sure, if you use standard, you can improve very, very fast the use of your data. You need also a legal framework very good. What is a legal framework? I explained to you better in the part where I show you how to publish data. But a legal framework is important to create a easy system to understand the data, what is possible to do and what is not possible to do. And if you use a legal framework very, very easy, it's more possible that the people start to use the data and you can start to do everything. The regulation is another point. The point about trust, you can think about one of the benefits is the trust, but also the probability. Because, for example, if you start to say, now, I offer my data around the world, the people around the world read my data, other companies read my data, customers read my data, and say, oh, this is very, very good, this company is good, and I improve my trust. And later, if you improve the trust, if you work on the trust, the use of your data is very, very, can be better. In some cases, some companies, for example, I think about Airbnb. I think everybody knows Airbnb, and with Airbnb, the company sometimes open the data. There are other companies that extract the data, scrape the data from Airbnb, but Airbnb started to open the data, some data, because there is a good effect with the public administration. It's the same also for Uber. Uber opened the data for this reason. In some cases, to understand what is possible, to improve, to understand better what is possible with the data, some company like Airbnb and Uber started to create some challenges. And if you are a company and you have a good data and you think, I want to improve my relationship with our company, I want to understand better what is possible to create with my data, you can try to create a challenge. I think for a startup, maybe it's not so easy now because of the few steps. But if you think again, this is a suggestion how improve your business with the open data. So you plan some benefit, but you need some action. If the action, the probability to expand this benefit, are good, you have a big chance to conquer the market. This is on the left side, and this is a good side where you start your dreams and you start everything, what is possible, you think now we can do a very, very good market, we can expand everything. If you look on the right, count the cost. And this is important. understand the cost, because the cost of the business, competitive cost, opportunity cost. If you think, if you are sure you are the only one in the world that has this kind of data, maybe open the data is not a good idea. Maybe, I don't know. It depends on the point of view. My point of view is always better open the data. But in any case, you have to think, if I open this kind of data, what happened around me? For example, the company involved in energy, this kind of companies don't like to open the data, because if a company starts to open the data and the other company doesn't open the data, what happened? The other company can study the data and say, now we can try to create a new kind of offer. You can think how open the data to preserve your point, your position in the market, and how create a new network with other people. So the business costs are important to study. The legal costs and risk are not so easy, because in any case you have to think, okay, I open the data, and now I have to say to the world, I open the data, please use my data. You have some public relation cost. You have to understand if the payment for this action is important or not important for you. If the costs are too much, maybe you think it's not possible. There are also the problem related to privacy. You have to study your data to understand if you close the data. If you think, again, one of the review made by the reviewer of FINODEX is pay attention to some issues like privacy. So maybe you collect personal data, and if you open the data, you have to think about privacy. You can open the data to show to the other customer what is the power of your product, but you need always to protect the customers. You can solve this in two directions, or create a legal system, so ask, create a contract where the people register in your platform and say, sign a section where you can do what you want with the data of the people. I don't know if it's possible, but in any case you have to pay someone ready to write for you a privacy policy to understand what you can do. And later you have to aggregate the data together. So there are always a cost and risk that you have to understand in your project. And there are later the cost through the cost through of the technical cost. The cost to open the data, related to create a platform to distribute the data, the cost of the quality of the data and other. So I think after this study, I go back very fast, after this study you have a clear idea on on the red branch there is the cost, and the other are related to the benefit. You have a clear idea what are the action that you have to do to open your data. A reviewer suggested to you, open the data because you can improve your market. Okay, this is important. So it is there. I can improve my market. But how? I have to understand what is the best way to improve your market. Later, you have to say, to look to the other side, the cost to create this system, to open the data in this case. And I think if you have this clear idea, you have to write for each data set a different action. Later, you understand if it's a good idea to open the data or not open the data, if you are ready to open the data. Now, how publish open data? This is very, very easy. Before to begin, you have to remember the definition. Open means anyone can freely access, reuse, modify, and share for any purpose. And this means open data. But if you look to the other section, there are the restrictions, preserve provenance and openness. If you move a step over about this definition, you have three kinds of vision. You have the vision related to the legal issue, the technological issue, and the issue related to documentation. Because if you want that the people are free to access, you need a legal issue. But you don't need not only the legal issue, you need also to create some technical system easy for the people. You can use open format, like in this example. The people here send the file in open format. You can use open protocols. You can use API. If you use API, you have more possibility to distribute data very fast. In any case, you have also to think what is your customer. Because if you think to companies, it's better, or developer, it's better if you use API. If you think to normal customer, maybe it's better if you distribute file in open format. Not a good idea, use a closed format, because for the people need to have the software to open this kind of format. And if you want that the people can access freely the data, you need documentation. If I show you a table with a lot of number and I don't explain to you what is the mean of each number of the column and all that, you can't understand what is. So you say, I open the data, but for the people it's very, very hard. Related to the legal aspect, I show you later, but is everything related to the permission to use. For this reason, I use this kind of icon. This is the copyleft icon. It's a game with the words, copy right, so permission to copy, and copy left, and there is the game also with the picture, but it's only related to the permission to copy. So, if you start to open the data, the first point is you need data. You don't need documents, you need data. So the first point is the creation data in machine-readable format. And you are a finalist of FINODEX, you are a developer, or you work a lot with the developer, and you know what is a machine-readable system. But it's very easy to understand. You can think like a table. You have a table, the table is a machine-readable format. Please don't use table to explain the data. For example, now is a clean table, but if you have a lot of number, it's not a good idea to add a number with a total of the number, because this is a representation. You need to transport the data, not to display the data, at two different point of view. Second point, use open format. And I think it is very, very clear. Now it is a major, I don't suggest the use of Excel. I suggest the use of CSS or XML, but you know, CSS and XML are different kind of data, but you can also use API or web services. What is important? The use of the format. These two images are very different between, but I like a lot because this image, very, very boring, is related to the structure of a database. Here we have a table. For each column, you have the kind of data. So for example, here there is a date, here there is a number, here there is a text, and everything is connected with other kind of tables. Sometimes the people show table with a lot of number, for example, the column category. You find the column category and there are a lot of number. What mean these numbers? What is 1, 2, 3, 4? You need also to connect with other table, and you can explain what is inside the column category means this kind of table, and to show the other table. Another point important is to explain, and this is the Rosetta Stone, I think you know, different kind of word, to explain what is the name of the column. Because we have here name. Name has a lot of different meaning. So explain better is always a good idea. You can use a different kind of format, and each format connects with a community. I told you before, if you use a CSS file, you speak more with normal users or with the developers. If you use XML, XML is more for developers as for normal users, because normal user open the file, double click, and want to read the data. And if you open XML, depends on the kind of XML, because if you think Excel, for example, is also XML. But double click and show the data. And what is important, the use of the format, because each kind of format, a different kind of community, I explained to you before. But there are also some kind of format where you can define the structure of the table and also the vocabulary connected. XML is one of the best way. You can use it. What is better, if you think again about the calculus for open data, what is better always look to the standards. Understand what is the best standard used from the community which you want to speak. In my point of view, if you can offer different kind of format, and this for you is very, very easy, if I say easy, I mean related to the software used by you, it's better. Better if you can distribute different kind of format or for the same file, if you can. If you can't, it's not possible. It's better you stay in another direction. Another point is the permission. So you select your data set after a study inside the company. After selecting the data set, you say, now, okay, now I need to use I want to use this kind of format. The format is open, but the format is also the communication with the people. But you need also the license. There are three kind of license. The family, the license without restriction, the family where you have to remember the provenance, and the family to evolve with the openness of the data set. I show you better now. The first example is a public domain. The permission is you can do what you want. You can share, create, adapt. You can do what you want. I ask you nothing. This is the best way for the companies, for the users, for the people that want to use open data. Maybe for the provider, no, it's not so nice. Depends. Maybe if, with, if you are famous or you begin to be famous, it's better if you start to use the Creative Commons Zero, because Creative Commons Zero is a public domain. Because the people, okay, the people, the restrictions are not present, but the people say, ah, nice, this company is good because this company give me the data set in public domain, so I can do what you want. It's nice. You can't track what happened from the data set. The people can forget you. So can be good or not good. The solution are all public domain, but to have some in public domain in Europe, you need that the owner, you have to wait the death of the owner after 70 years. In the case of databases, if there is no update, you can wait 20 years after the last update, because there is another kind of IPR on the data. It's always complicated to say if there is IPR on the data. You say IPR, intellectual property right. What is intellectual in the collection of data? The collection of the data is not so important. I say there is no creativity behind. But the structure of the data, maybe there is a creativity. So public domain is, is very hard to obtain, but if you want to use, you can use Creative Commons Zero. You go to creativecommons.org, and this is the document, very important. You can add all your data set, or you can add. When you show the data, you can add the information related to the license. If you use a format where you can write inside the attribute related to the data, related to the license, I suggest you to use it also, to use too. Because if I go to the website of the company, there is a section related to open data. I find the files or the API or web services or what you want. And I read the license, it's nice. But if I want also distribute, if I use a API or I use a format, I carry the attribute where is the name of the license. Creative Commons Zero is a license, a document, where there is a sentence very easy. Everything is inside this content, data, document, picture, and other, you can use what you want in the respect of the law of my country. This is very, very easy. It's more complicated for the lawyer. In the other kind of family is the attribution licenses. And this is most used from the government around the world. Each government or use Creative Commons attribution, this kind of license, or create a new license. If you read this license, there is all the restriction, remember me. If you're a company, you can create your license. In my point of view, is a big cost without a good solution. Because if you use a Creative Commons license, a lot of people around the world know what is a Creative Commons, and the people are ready to understand what are the permissions, what are the restrictions. The attribution, you have only to remember the provenance. You know, every time that the people use the data, has to add the provenance. What is good for you? If you're a company, you say, I use the attribution, so the people have to remember me. And you can use attribution in two different ways. The light way or the hard way. The light way is, for example, you say in your presentation, when you present the data, you can use the Creative Commons, the data in a Creative Commons attribution. So the data, every time you use the data, you have to remember me. And the light fashion, you have to remember me, or with a website, or with the name of the company, or with the name or the URL of the data set, or you want, but easy. What is the other point of view? The solution is a hard attribution, and you can write. Every time you use the data set, this attribution should be very, very easy to understand for the people, and should be on the first page of the application, and blah, 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 blah. And this kind of attribution is tricky, but maybe can be useful for you. You have to remember, you are the owner of the data, so you can change the license all you want. So you can use the system of the dual license. Use a license for open data and a license for private data, closed data. The kind of closed data, you have to define the distribution, you have to define the rate of the updated, you can use what you want, and you can use different kind of licenses because you are the owner. If you are not the owner, you can't do this. One point is create a very, very verbose license for the attribution. So some people say, I need to use your data in my smartphone, but the display is very, very little, I can't use the attribution. So you can say, you can pay for this. I don't know if you have success with kinds of license, but is one of the solutions. In my point of view, if you think only about marketing, strategy to connect with other company, strategy to create a trust around your company, to improve your accountability, in my point of view, it's better if you use all CC0, or better, CC0 is if you are famous. If you are not famous, better use Creative Commons attribution, and in a light way. This data comes from this company. Please, every time you use it, you have only to remember this data comes from this company. So the people can begin know you by using by other people. The third solution of license is Creative Commons, the share-alike licenses. The share-alike licenses are, the permission are always share, create, adapt, but the restrictions are a little bit tricky because there is the attribution, so the provenance is like before, the share alike and the always open. What mean? Share alike is you have to use always the same license. You can't change the license. And the restriction of this license is that you have always, you can't close the data. The data are always open. These cases are related to Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike or the ODBL. ODBL is the license used by OpenStreetMap, Open Database License. What happened? In the case of Creative Commons Attribution, is very, very tricky. Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike. The Share Alike is very easy. So if you have data, and from the data you create a map, for example, a graph, the new graph, the new picture, is also Creative Commons attribution share alike, because it's a product from the first product. And later, if you put this graph inside an article, and if this graph is very important for the article, maybe also the article has to be share alike, so you can't close. It's very viral. Later, there is always a discussion related to the board, but it's tricky. ODBL is less tricky, but it's always tricky. And this means if you modify the data or add data to this database, the database is always open. You can't close it. What you, the product, the new product, you can use the license what you want. You can say the graph, the map, the blanket, if you start from the data to create a blanket, for example. This is not open. The data are open. All the products are not open. But on each product, you have to have the attribution. To add the attribution, you have to write this data come from blah, blah, blah. And this is most used from some very famous company, very startup, open data startup. One of the best is Open Corporate. Open Corporate offers the data in two different ways, the community data and the private data. The community data are with ODBL. The private data are without ODBL. And if you collect the data with ODBL and you add data, later you have to open also your data. If you use the data of Open Corporate and you pay to have the other kind of license, you can do what you want. In the case of OpenStreetMap, it's nice because the people collaborate and the common, the treasure, the product, the best solution of OpenStreetMap are the data. So you have to open the data. In other cases, you have to think, or you can use the license for your business. Happens or the position of your company on the market. For example, if you are famous and you studied what are the best data that you can open, and you think by opening this data you can conquer the market, you can use C0. If you are not so famous, you can use CBY. If you want to use the case of CBY SA or ODBL, you have to think a little bit and say, what are the data that you have? Because if the data that you have are very important, joined with other data, I think ODBL is a good solution. If you think your data alone are not so important, maybe it's a little bit complicated to use this kind of license. But my goal, what I want to say to you is, if you choose a license, it's very important to think also what is the effect that you want to have. It's not only standard, technological standard, but there is also some question related to the legal issue. After you choose your data, you have to publish your data. And there are a lot of websites where you can publish your data. In my point of view, you are the owner. If I go to your company, I want to have the section open data, because you are the company. And if you are a startup company, you say, we are a startup company, a open data provider company, you need to have a section related to open data. If you are an open data startup, a consumer, a startup that uses open data, okay, you have always to remember, because there are a lot of licenses, you have to remember we use the data from and other. If you are a data provider, it's better if you have a section related to open data. Later, you can park your data on a data portal, but in my point of view, you are a company. Your goal is the market. So it's better if you have the data in your house. So the people see the data and say, you have this kind of data, but if the people want more data with more quality, updated, fresh, and other, these people are always to knock on your house, always to go by you and ask the data. So, if you have a section related to open data, it's better. You can use different portals around the world to publish your data as a PR issue. You say, okay, now we publish the data on the data portal of this city, so the people can read that we have this data, and we are the producer of this data, and the people are ready to speak with us. It's only to like have advertisement in internet or on a newspaper. It's the same. In any case, if you publish the data on an open data portal, you need to find the right open data portal. Not all the data portal made by the government offer the possibility for the private to publish the data. In my point of view, if you think to have very sexy data with the government, it's better if you start to speak with the government. Government can be a city or a nation or an office. It's not so important, but what is important is the section related to open data. You can ask to park your data also to publish. If you think about open data portal, the right way is catalogs, not portal. Because there are like the catalogs of IKEA, where you have your newspaper with your catalog, you read each page, and for each page you have information related to the products. The open data catalogs are the same. There are all other kind of open data catalog like Socrata, made by USA. If you go to data.gov, but data.gov now I think is SICAN. Or also SICAN. SICAN is the open data platform made by Open Knowledge International, and now is used around the world from a lot of different government. You can also think to create your platform made with SICAN. For example, SICAN is open source, because maybe you collect this kind of knowledge, and maybe you can create a plugin to expand the publisher of your data with others, and you can offer also another kind of service, but it's another story. If you look around the world from different kind of data portal, for example, Fiverr offer a data portal. And what I want to show you better is, I told you information related to related to open data, to the document, very important that you have documents to explain better or use the data. I explained to you, it's better if you together with the data explain also the structure, you use also the vocabulary. But if you put the data inside the open data portal, you have also to add other kind of information. If you think like the schedule where you collect data, over each schedule there are the some important data, metadata, to find the data. So, if you publish the data, you need also to add some metadata important to have the data discoverable for everybody. What I mean? You have the data to explain to the people, for example, yeah, to explain to the people, for example, what is the frequency of date of the data. Explain to the people what are the number, what is the last time of the update, who is the provider, and other. The Europe, based from a very important standard made by the W3C, created a DCAT. DCAT is a document to explain to you how add metadata to the data set. And if you go here on the website of Europe, join up, you can find all the information related, what are the very important metadata for your data. For example, there is also the size of the data set, there is the documentation, there is also the area, geographical area, where the data set is good or not good, and other. You can improve the DCAT, or if you use some of the most used open data portal around the world, you can use all, not always, but in most of cases the DCAT is inside. My suggestion is read, I understand it's boring, but if you want to improve the publish of your data. It's very important to read this specification and find what is used for you, good for you. Maybe if you start, and this is also my suggestion, to have a section related to open data in your website, in the website of the company, I suggest you to explain the data like in an open data catalog and use the same vocabulary made by DCAT. DCAT is more as a vocabulary, you have the vocabulary, but the description of the data is in a format RDF, because are linked data, the metadata of DCAT, and this is very useful because if you open your data and you offer the you offer the catalog in the DCAT protocol, later all the kind of systems that collect data from different data portal can include the information related to the, your data set inside the data portal. So my goal with you, what I want to say to you is use DCAT. If you open, if you create a section, use DCAT, because by using DCAT later there are more possibility for other catalog around the world to publish what you produce. Again, so publish the data. I want to repeat everything. First point, you have to use data in machine for a machine readable format. So structure the data. Use a format to transport the data and not to visualize the data. First point. Second point, use standard. Use open format. Better if you use format in different format, because each kind of format touch a different kind of community. So you have to understand if you want to speak with the developers, if you want to speak with customers, you have to understand what is the best format. If you speak only with the developer, maybe you can use only API. If you speak with the developer and also with the data analyst and also with the customers, it's better if you use file poor like CVS. Very important, add together with the format the documentation. If you use format very rich like XML, like RDF, you can improve also the information related to the structure of the dataset for each column and also the vocabulary used. Third point is the use of a license. And I show you the different kind of license. The public domain license is not a license, because public domain is not a license, because you say you can do what you want. We say the attribution license, and we say the share alike license. Different kind of licenses offer to you three different possibilities to open the data, to create a business related to data. The public domain is good if you want to work more to your responsibility, public relations, to say that you're good and all that. The attribution is a system to remember to the people that you are the data producer. And the share alike is a system to create a contact with the users, with the users of the data, because the users of the data, or work with you with the open by create a common, or ask to you to change the license. What is very important is to remember that you are the owner of the data, so you can change the copyright. Last point, publish the data on an open data portal. I suggest you to create an open data section in your website. Use DCAT to describe the metadata, because you are more discoverable for the other data catalog around the world. Again, if you choose your data set, you can use the calculus by open data showed before. This calculus where you have probability, multiplicative for benefit, plus duty. If are more to the cost, you open the data. But this is a very nice tool made by Open Data Institute. The website is Open Data Pathway, but I show you now the website. So, open this, pathway.deoli.org. This is very nice because you can track the process to show your data. Now, I registered, so I have to do this, and if I can't do, sorry. oh, sorry, because I can't remember the password because I changed the computer for you. In any case, what I want to show to you is does this application help you to have a lot of questions to understand the maturity level of your open data, of your data. And it's very important because by using this system, you have to answer for each question, you understand better the process to create the data, and by this process, later, you explain better, you have better a system to have more quality of your data, because it's very easy to understand, better are your data, and more are your possibility to have to be famous. It's very hard because if you have to protect the privacy of the users, you have to aggregate the data, and more the data are aggregated, and less are user are good to use. But in any case, this system helps you to track the progress of your system, and I suggest you also some solution related to the privacy or how to acquire the ownership of the data. Now, the first point was understand how open the data, the second point is how publish the data, and now there are other questions made by the FINODEX reviewer. One question is include more data. The answer to include more data is hard, because this means you have to add data from other data provider. And you can try to find, for example, one of the questions that a lot of people say to me, I need data from crimes, I need data of food. And the answer is, where I can find a data provider that collect all the data? It is very hard, very, very hard. Maybe this can be one of the markets that you can discover in the future. Now you work on your project. But to solve the question of your project, you start to collect data, you start to include more data, you start to include data from different data provider. So maybe it's good for you to think another way for the future to improve your business. Because if you have the problem to collect data from different data provider that speak about food, your job is find the data set, find the data provider, understand the model, understand what happened, and maybe by the aggregation of the data, you start to create your personal model, or you use a model in a standard not very famous now, and maybe you can create your model, your standard, or you can use a standard made by other people. And later you create this common, and maybe you can offer this data set as open data. Not all the data set, only a piece of data set, but is important for you. But how discover data? It's very hard. I suggest you this website, but it's not easy. The best solution is a little funny to say, but is the use of search engine like Google, Yahoo, and other. But in this case, in this place, you can find a different data portal. My suggestion is, if you, for example, find the data on a website around the world, very important for you, and you understand there is a connection between this data provider with the government or one of the catalog present in the website, you can try to speak with the owner of the data catalog portal with the data provider that you want to have the data. Maybe you can create, in this direction, you can create a team to add the data, because it's always hard have more data. But again, think again about the possibility to solve your problem for other people. Maybe you find data related to food in North America and in Africa, but the structure of the data are different, but you work a lot to have only one model, and now you have a solution for other people, and maybe you can ask for the people for Europe, for example, to use your model to improve the data. And maybe your application is, give me your data, I give you the data in a standard mode, and now you can improve your process maybe by using an application. Another, the website data portals is a comprehensive list of open data portals around the world, but it is more related to open data by public administration. Another good solution is use Data Hub. Hub is an open data portal. If you want, you can publish your data on open data in datahub.io. If you publish your data in datahub.io, you obtain also the possibility to publish your data, but maybe you can find other kind of organization ready to publish data. Okay. Another question made by the FINODEX reviewer is use global resources. In my point of view, this kind of review, use global resources, is more related to how you have to expand your business. Because the use of global resources to expand your business means that if you work only on a city, later it's hard to expand your model to other places. This is related with the problem before. How we can find more data set is a big problem, is a big issue, and we have to work. And again, my suggestion is, if you find a solution, later you can offer your solution for other companies by opening the data. In any case, my point of view is better if you start, depends on the kind of application. If your application that is that you can use around the world, or you can use, it's not so important the place where you are, you can use a global resource. If you start from local, you need to find what is the problem, because the problem in a city is the same in another city, but try to create a model where the people later add the data in your system, and maybe you solve it for other people. It's hard because we speak, to create a global resource, we need to speak about model, about standard. And it's always a problem. I don't have a solution, but I can have for you a solution for some very famous global resources. One of the first is OpenStreetMap. I think a lot of people know OpenStreetMap. OpenStreetMap is a system, it's a website like Wikipedia, where the people collect data around the world. If you go to the website OpenStreetMap, what is very nice for me is the presence of the word modify. If you look here, edit, you can modify what happened in OpenStreetMap. I can't remember my password again. I can try again, the last, no, stop. I don't want to use it. In any case, what happened? You can edit what is inside the and what happens in these pages, you can move. Here, you can ask, for example, data. Because if you ask map data, here, the system begin download the data from internet and show you not only the picture of the map, but also the data over the map. So you see, if you look, for example, this point that is not present on the map, here I have information what is. It is present on the map because this is a place, but you have information, for example, here related to the bus stop, or here you have information related to the name of the way, and other. This is, everything is our data. For example, here is present the traffic signal and other kind of information related to this. And you can download the file in XML. If you start from here, you are very crazy if you want to try to download everything. So what is the solution? OpenStreetMap offer a solution. The name is Planet, planet.openstreetmap.org, and from here you can download all the data set. If you look here, the data set is very, very big, and this is not the best solution for you. But before to download the data, it's important to understand how the data are collected. Okay, the first point, the people collect the data from in different way. Some people collect the data from open data, or find the open data portal, find the data, and start to do this very, very hard job suggested to you before. Use, transform the model of the data provider to the model of OpenStreetMap. And now begin very good design, because what is inside OpenStreetMap use the same model. And you have a complete resource around the world. What is inside OpenStreetMap? OpenStreetMap use the tag. So you have the first tag, the key, and the value. For example, if you want to find the amenity related to the polis, you use this kind of information, amenity equals polis. And you can use in different kind of way. If you can use to describe a point, or to describe area, or to describe a polyline. Or polyline or a line. Depends what is if close or not close. So there is the geometry, and there are also the attribute. The attribute are a lot of tag. If you look again this page, I show you crossing, traffic signal. Crossing is the amenity, is the key. Traffic signal is the value. And I can also add other kind of information. For example, here there is a restaurant, and I have amenity restaurant. This is the first key. But I can add different kind of information. For example, here I have the kind of cuisine in this restaurant. This is pizza and regional food. The name, the name. There is also, if you want to pay with Bitcoin, there is a possibility. There is the phone number and other. Or you can say you can add a lot of different different tags. If you want to extract the data, you can use the planet that I showed you before, or there are also the API to extract the data. For example, I want to have all the amenity polis in Trentino. Trentino is my region. I use this wizard. I write this information, this query. I start to ask the system information. The system start, ask to OpenStreetMap to update the data, and I open last time, give me back the data. Okay, click here to show the data, and here I have all the places where is the police station in my region. Here there is the query, the language that you have to use if you want create everything in a system to communicate by machine to machine, not with people, person to machine. And here, if you have the data, later you can export. And you can export in different kind of format. For example, GeoJSON is a format, GPX is a format, KMN is another format, and other. I can download in JSON, I create the file now, and later I can use it in another kind of application. For example, this is UMAP. With this application, I can upload the JSON file, and later I can do what you want. What is important now is GeoJSON, GPX, KML, or directly the connection to Overpass API. If you look here on Overpass API, if you look here where is the URL, it is under create this kind of query to be used on the map, sorry, on the server to extract the data. If you want to use this data in UMAP, I use UMAP OpenStreetMap FR, and here I can upload the file. It's low now, so I don't want to use too much time about this. I think this is good for you if you need data, because with this kind of data, you can extract data directly from OpenStreetMap, and you have only to understand what are the features. If you go here on the wiki.openstreetmap.org, you can find the feature. It's so important, this page, that if you go to the page of OpenStreetMap or the wiki, is present here on the left. And the page is very, 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 very long. You find a lot of different information, and you can understand from the people involved in OpenStreetMap or the data. The people in OpenStreetMap use data by open data resources, by knowledge of the places, because add a label to say the name of the street is a knowledge, a local knowledge. I can go here, modify the name, and use also information collected with GPS, and information collected from different kind of sources. For example, some people use the invoice. On the invoice, there is the address number, and that the address number on the map. I understand that in some cases are not so useful, but is a common resource that you can try to use. Not so useful because the people say, yes, but you use open data made by people, and I think you are not happy. I suggested you before, Planet Osmart, a lot of data. There is the weekly Planet XML file, the weekly chainset, so the change of the data. There are a lot of projects that extract the data from Planet Osm and create also some kind of data not so big like the complete world, only for a region and other. But what is important is this project, sorry, not this project, because I read in some review, or by speaking also with some of you, usually there is a problem to have a map. A lot of people use Google Maps, other people use OpenStreetMap. The use of OpenStreetMap is nice because maybe the representation on the map. But if you want to show your data on the map, because you collect data with your application, and you want to show the data for your application to have a better map. But your data are not so much, because to create a map you need the streets, you need the point of interest, you need a lot of different kind of information. Your data inside the OpenStreetMap are not so much. But maybe you want to create your personal system to have the map under your website. So my suggestion is go to this website, switch to Osm. This is one of the possibility. There are a lot of kind of possibility. If you need to have other kind of information, you have only to ask me, and I can suggest you other solution without problem. You can write me, and I can give you other kind of information. You have to remember, inside OpenStreetMap, there are not only maps, the geographical data, because there are other kind of data I showed you before. In this website, you have some case studies of company that switched from Google Maps or Bing or other kind of information to OpenStreetMap. But you have information to understand the base of OpenStreetMap, to understand how to extract the data, how to create a complete chain to build a map, or to create a geocoder and other. A system to create tiles. The tiles are the all the map in the ground to use, or serving and other. So if you need this kind of information to create your personal map, because maybe the use of OpenStreetMap or the use for Google, there are too much traffic, and later your application create too much traffic, and Google ask you too much money, or OpenStreetMap say to you to please fair use of the map, you can try to create this system only for you. In my point of view, it's good to create your personal maps. If you want to have some idea about maps that you can have with OpenStreetMap, if you go into this website and see .bbbbike.org, you can compare different kind of map. In this case, the first is OpenStreetMap, this is Google, this is again OpenStreetMap, but you can find a lot of different maps, and you can also use not 3, 4, 2 maps, without to be crazy, in different kind of language also, and this is also nice, because you can try to understand what is the best map for you. Maybe another kind of map made by OpenStreetMap that you can use for your purpose. And I want to use the map made by Mapbox. The story of Mapbox is nice because Mapbox is a startup that uses geographical data and created the big business by using OpenStreetMap. Now we have Mapbox and also Dirka are two different startups that use the OpenStreetMap data. But in the story of Mapbox, there is, for example, Foursquare. Foursquare started to use the map of Google, but the traffic made by Foursquare is too big and to pay is too much, so Foursquare use, in some cases, Google Maps, in other cases, use Mapbox, different kind of price of the map. I go back to this presentation. Other solution that we have, we can do. Other common solution is also Wikipedia. And I understand, I found a lot of people that use Wikipedia for the... I don't know if you know also DBpedia. DBpedia is based on the data made by Wikipedia. I'll show you again from our website what happened. I go in Wikipedia in Italian language only because it's better for me, but it's not so important. It's only to show you. This is a page related to my city in Wikipedia. I can also change in English if you want. And if you look at the edit, if you edit here, there are some information structured. There is the name of the city. There is, for example, the number of people. There is the postal code, zip code, area. There are a lot of information inside the page, and the page, this kind of information here. DBpedia, what do you do? DBpedia creates this data inside from Wikipedia in structural data, linked data. It's very easy. If you have, for example, if I go to DBpedia, I go to DBpedia in Italian language, but it is in English because I like this system. If I have here, I write, for example, Trento, the name of my city. I search Pamplona, where is Zabala of FINODEX. Pamplona. Sorry. I can find the relation between the two pages and the connection of the data. So I try to use the relation. I use the resource Trento. I use the resource Pamplona. And the system now begin to discover what is Trento and what is Pamplona, and try and find the connection between the two cities. Understand that Pamplona is a populated place, is a municipality like Trento, and find the connection between the two cities. In this case, I use the cities, but I can use also concept like object, people, and other kind of ontology. Maybe this is also useful to discover a connection with other kind of data that you can have. Okay, this is nice to see, but it's not useful for you. It's nice to understand what is. It's more useful is the extracted data from DBpedia. I use the English version. Here, there are the example how you can ask to the Wikipedia information. For example, you won't find all the black and white Italian movies which soundtrack composer was born in a Trentino Alto Adige, my region, city, with less than 4,000 inhabitants. Okay, we can start to find all the movie produced in, produced in Italy. Very easy, there is a query here. Use this kind of structure of language, and you can obtain the data in different format, HTML, CSV, spreadsheet, XML, JSON, and other. You run the query, and now I asked to Wikipedia all the data related to film made in Italy, movie made in Italy. I can also later ask, I want only the black and white film. I can ask what are the soundtrack composer for film made in Italy. This is better because I connect together the concept related to movie, the concept related to country, the resource Italy. I ask the kind of film, of movie, and I ask the name of the composer. And I ask also to filter to black and white by using this. Now, need a little bit more time. Today I have a lot of fortune with you because every time I use the system is very, very slow. In any case, there is this kind of language and you can expand, 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 expand. If you want to have, this is the last query that you can, use. Okay, I use. This is the number of the city, black and white, and together with the name of the composer of the music, the soundtrack. If you want to have the complex, this is the more complex because I ask movie, I ask country, I ask the kind of film, I ask the name of the music composer, I ask the birthplace of the music composer, I ask to find a city in the region Trentino Alto Adige with a population less as 4,000 people. And the system gives me the name. No, this is not the solution, is another kind of solution. Yeah. I see. Okay. So inquiry. And the composer is Riccardo Zandonai, and he created 4 films related to this topic. My suggestion on the use of global resources is only to give you some feedback to use some commons like Wikipedia and OpenStreetMap to improve better the use of open data in your system. You have to remember the licenses used in OpenStreetMap and in Wikipedia are share-alike licenses. Okay, now the last, but very, very last because I am closing my webinar. If you have a question, but I can't see on the website, on the system, or the webinar if there are questions. I think you are ready to begin your business. If you want, as FINODEX project, we created this project to explain you better the issue related to this video, sorry, to explain you better the issue related to the how discover data and the issue related to the license. The first point to understand is a data is open data, the use of the license. And this video is only to explain to you everything. We can use, but I suggest you better to look directly online. You can use this slide. This slide now, we published this slide on the website of FINODEX. But if you go on YouTube and you go to the FINODEX channel, you find everything. I am closing. If you need to speak with me, you can find here my contact. I want to summarize everything again for the last time. What I show, I explained to you today in this webinar is the first point. We found that the best way to improve the finalists in FINODEX, because all the people finalists in FINODEX are very good with the concept of open data. The concept of open data is the use, reuse, and share of data without problem, maybe to remember the provenance and to have always the openness of the data. But this is not so important. What is very important is the use of the data without problem. Later we find some a solution, a calculus to understand how open your data. It's not a calculus related to what is open data and all that. It's only a calculus to understand what they have to do to improve the openness of the data, because if you open the data, you can improve your market, you can create a new strategy, you can speak with other company, you can speak with customer, you can have more visibility around the world. And the suggestion of the calculus is the use of the data, understand what is your goal, together with your goal, improve with the probability to open the data by using standard, by speaking with the people, by creating challenges and other. And to the other side, we have to understand the cost of these operations, and this is important. Later, I show you how open the data. In the four steps, very, very easy. The first step is the use of structured data, so data in machine-readable format. The second point is the use of an open format or format with a lot of documentation. The third point is the use of a license, and I explain to you the different kind of model of license and how use the different kind of license to improve your business, because you can play with the dual licensing concept. You can offer some data set, maybe old, maybe aggregated as open data, and offer data set fresh and other as open data. As closed data with another kind of license. Or another solution explained during the webinar is the use of a share-alike license, because the share-alike license is nice but is also boring for the companies. So you can offer the data set in a share-alike license or in closed license. If you pay to have a closed license, you can do what you want with the data. The last point is publish the data. My suggestion is to create a section related to open data in your website. And if you create the suggestion is the use of a lot of documentation based in DCAT. It is a vocabulary made by W3C and now used by the European Commission for the Open Data Portal. So by offer the data in DCAT, you are more discoverable for the other open data portal. In any case, the suggestion is use a section in an open data portal. I show you some different open data portal. There is the data portal of Fireware. There is also the data portal of different public administration. I showed you datahub.io. There are a lot of data portal. The suggestion is use this to expand your visibility, or use it to create a relation with the data provider, to say to the data provider, if you open, you can use the data portal and you can use also my data set, and later you start to discuss together with the data provider. After the steps to publish the data, I showed you some important resources. One resource is datacatalog.org, another resource is datahub.io. And later I show you how to extract data from the two most famous common resources made by community, OpenStreetMap and Wikipedia. How use the data from OpenStreetMap by using, for example, planet.org or planet.openstreetmap.org or Overpass Turbo. And with Overpass Turbo is a front-end for Overpass API, API for OpenStreetMap, and show you also how to use the data to create your personal map provider by using the information in Switch to OSM. Later, with Wikipedia, I showed you the information that you can extract or direct from Wikipedia or with Wikipedia by using the power of linked data. I think this is everything. If you have a question, you can ask me, or you can contact me by email without problem. I am always here ready. Thank you.